Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Now that we know a bit more about alkoxides, let's revisit SN2 reactions that use alkoxides as nucleophiles. On the screen, we have the same SN2 reaction shown two different ways. The top one is just a reaction of a primary halide with sodium ethoxide and ethanol to form a new CO bond. The presentation of the reaction features the alkyl halide as the key starting material. Sodium ethoxide, our nucleophile, is a reagent on the arrow with the solvent of ethanol. This is one way to show alkoxides in an SN2 reaction. The other way is shown below. Often when alkoxides are used as nucleophiles, the reaction will be broken up into two steps, a step for making the alkoxide and a step for the SN2. In this case, we show our alcohol, ethanol, as our main starting material. In the first step, we would form the alkoxide. We've used sodium hydride as the base. Once the ethoxide nucleophile has been formed, we can then add, in the second step, the alkyl halide. In this second step, the SN2 reaction occurs and we get our product. In both presentations, we get the same product. The second is more explicit about forming the alkoxide. The product of this reaction forms a new CO bond. Made a little bit bolder. The new CO bond, this represents an ether, an R prime. Reactions that form an ether through an SN2 reaction are called a Williamson ether synthesis. That is the title of this slide. Williamson ether syntheses are very often depicted in two steps, like the lower second reaction. The first step is a deprotonation to form the alkoxide, and the second step is addition of the alkyl halide for the SN2 reaction.